The door to Walt Disney is now open with a special 25th anniversary edition of Bedknobs and Broomsticks. Then it's the Ink and Paint Club right here on Disney. Welcome to Walt Disney's Bedknobs, Broomsticks, and Beyond.
Hello, I'm Angela Lansbury, and tonight I'd like you to join me for a special presentation of the restored Disney classic, Bedknobs and Broomsticks. It's a wonderful movie full of music,
it's lovely,
magic, and tonight, scenes you've never seen before, and a look at how we shot them. So join me for Walt Disney's Bedknobs, Broomsticks, and Beyond.
When it was released in 1971, Disney's Bedknobs and Broomsticks became an instant classic, but the on-screen adventure is only half the story. At the same time Walt Disney was developing Mary Poppins, he discovered another story he couldn't resist, that of an apprentice witch.
My first broom.
Who takes in three young World War II refugees.
You're not suggesting that I should take these children into my house?
She don't frighten me.
Pedigree? Perugy.
Oh, Charlie!
Bother, I never seem to be able to manage two.
But in order to premiere at the Radio City Music Hall, the 2.5-hour movie had to be shortened to under 2 hours, which meant cutting musical numbers, scenes, even co-star Roddy McDowell, who wound up with only a minute of screen time.
I shall be frank.
And while the film was nominated for 5 Academy Awards and went on to win 1 for Best Special Effects, it always seemed incomplete.
The movie as it was originally seen was enormously effective. And it's only those of us who knew what had originally been shot knew that pieces were missing.
But where's the other half now?
Oh, it's probably been thrown away. But if it still exists, there's only one place to find it.
So Disney set out in search of the missing footage.
We began looking by pulling up from the vaults all kinds of trim rolls and cans of film that hadn't been touched in many years. We also got a copy of the original shooting script to see what other pieces we might be missing.
When the search was over, 23 minutes of additional songs and scenes had been completely restored.
The results exceeded our expectations.
Traguna, Macoides, Tricorum, Satisti.
It pleases me enormously that this film is going to be reshown. It was my passport to an entire generation of youngsters. Now, those children are now grown up, and they are showing Bedknobs and Broomsticks to their kids.
See the movie the way it was meant to be. In just a few minutes, inside Walt Disney. Take the Walt Disney Challenge. Which song in Bedknobs and Broomsticks was originally written for another Disney classic? The Beautiful Briny, Portobello Road, A Step in the Right Direction, With a Flare. We'll be back in a moment with the answer. Magic spells, talking animals,
yes.
Flying beds. In Disney's Bedknobs and Broomsticks, special effects turn fantasy into reality.
How does she do that? Because she's a witch. That's the sort of thing witches do.
To fly is everybody's dream. And to have that experience of being suspended and moving freely through the air is a lovely, lovely feeling.
While some of the movie's special effects relied on wires and pulleys, others relied more on imagination.
It has to do with make-believe.
We have a volunteer referee!
Live-action characters seamlessly interact with animated animals. A process that requires actors to perform with characters they can't see.
Mm-hmm. We had to learn to understand that we were interacting with an animated creature.
Oh, that.
So your hand had to be in a certain position for him to put his hand in yours in the final print.
But animated animals were nothing compared with a magical army.
It takes you on an incredible journey. The flags going, suddenly things starting to rustle, and the bustle of the army suddenly coming alive.
But it took an army of another kind to transform a Burbank soundstage into a ghostly battlefield.
full marks to everybody who put the movie back together.
The result? Bedknobs and Broomsticks won an Academy Award for its special effects. And now you can see them all in the fully restored version.
To have the opportunity to see it at its best, and with all of the film that was removed, reinstated, and everything technical that could be done to improve it has been done, I think it's simply marvelous.
Don't go away. Bedknobs and Broomsticks is just a few minutes away inside Walt Disney. Which of the songs in Bedknobs and Broomsticks was originally written for another Disney classic? The Beautiful Briny was originally written by the Sherman Brothers for Mary Poppins.
Now, I'd like you to join me on an adventure. One that will take us from the blustery coast of England to an animated island where animals can actually talk. And it all starts with this. Ready?
In this scene from Disney's Bedknobs and Broomsticks, Angela Lansbury prepares to sing A Step in the Right Direction.
My first broom.
But the song never comes.
It was a great disappointment to me because I thought it was a lovely number. After all, it's a step in the right direction. It's a step in the right direction after all. And it enabled me to dance and sing on film, really, for the first time.
While the song appeared on the original cast album, it was cut before the movie was released, and over time, it disappeared.
They lost the film.
We began looking for the missing number, A Step in the Right Direction, and pulling cans out of the inventory of all kinds of trims and B-negative and such to see if it were there.
But the footage was never found.
It's a mystery. I have a feeling that somebody took it away and put it in a bag, and it's in a closet somewhere.
While we were not able to locate any of the picture portion of A Step in the Right Direction, we did find the stereo music track. And in the Walt Disney Photo Archive, we were able to find a large number of color pictures taken during the filming.
And that's what we present for you now. For the first time on television, A Step in the Right Direction.
I know it's old stuff to you. You've worked for witches with a great deal more experience than I have. But think of that magic moment when you saw your first mouse, the thrill that went through you. Perhaps it even got away, but that didn't matter, did it? It's a step in the right direction after all. After all, it's a step in the right direction. It's a step in the right direction after all. Watch the tiny tortoise inching up a hill. It may seem to you he's merely standing still. Though the steps he takes are infinitely small, they're a step in the right direction after all. It's a step in the right direction after all. After all, it's a step in the right direction. It's a step in the right direction after all. That brings back such memories. I hope you enjoyed watching the movie as much as I enjoyed making it. Thanks for watching Walt Disney's Bedknobs, Broomsticks, and Beyond. Good night. Shall we?